Hello everyone and welcome to Lost in the Real. Today I will be covering the How I Met Your Mother spinoff, aptly titled How I Met Your Father. This series has been in the works for over a decade, going through showrunner after showrunner, cast after cast, never seeming to be able to actually get itself off the ground. Now, 8 years after the original show said its goodbyes, Hulu has finally been able to bring this spinoff into fruition. But is it too little too late for How I Met Your Father? And is it able to recreate that magic from the original? Let's talk about it. How I Met Your Father is created by Isaac Apteker and Elizabeth Berger, inspired by the series How I Met Your Mother from Carter Bays and Craig Thomas. It stars Hilary Duff, Francia Risa, Tom Ainsley, Tien Tran, Saraj Sharma, Christopher Lowell, and Kim Cattrall. Sophie and her close-knit group of friends are in the midst of figuring out who they are, what they want out of life, and how to fall in love in the age of dating apps and limitless options. Let's start off this review by saying I used to be a huge fan of How I Met Your Mother in my college years. The show spoke to me in a way that felt true, when most shows at the time felt like they were talking down to me. The close-knit group of friends hanging out at their favorite watering hole, shooting the shit and falling in and out of love, all the while not being afraid to act silly, but certainly being afraid to grow up. The whole formula really resonated with me. But now, after revisiting it years later, although I still enjoy it for the nostalgia, its many issues are glaringly obvious. Ted Mosby is a narcissistic prick who only thinks of himself, and his hopeless romantic ways are irritating as hell. Marshall and Lily were a cute couple at first, but their cutesy coupley ways became way too saccharine sweet as the series went on, until they tried to mix all of that up and ultimately failed with that storyline. And then there was Neil Patrick Harris's Barney, who at the time seemed like the funniest character of the bunch. But rewatching the show now, I realize what an awful person he is, and his humor becomes overly repetitive until it's completely tiresome. So, the original is basically a show with grating characters, humor that lands about half the time and the rest is cringe, and basically hasn't aged all that well. So, where does that leave How I Met Your Father? Luckily, I think this new series has mended many of those issues, whilst still capturing what made people fall in love with the original to begin with. This starts with showrunners Isaac Apteker and Elizabeth Berger, who were both successfully able to translate Love, Simon to the small screen with Love, Victor, and are also producers on ABC's hit show This Is Us. These two were the perfect choices to take on this material because they understand situational comedy as well as adding emotional depth to their shows without them feeling too heavy. They have done a fine job taking what was already there and really revamping it for this day and age. What was really shocking to me is how they were able to make this feel exactly like you were watching an episode of the original. With the sound stages and laugh tracks, the sets that looked like they were just dusted off and redecorated, as well as the vibe of the show itself. Each episode has a breezy feel, coming and going quickly, with some kind of drama happening, but the stakes never being too high. And it's all wrapped up tightly with a bow. The bow in this case being the magic of the city. New York was a character all of its own in the original, and it is here as well. The feeling of coming of age, finding love, and that anything is possible in the hustle and bustle of the Big Apple is really showcased here in a way that is both fantastical and grounded in real life. The cast for this one is also game. Being a child of the 90s, I have always been a huge fan of Hilary Duff and have yearned for the actress to find the perfect leading role for her sensibilities. She was great in All in Younger, but let's be honest, that was Sutton Foster's show. Here she is able to show off all of her charm front and center in the spotlight. And then there's the rest of the cast, including Christopher Lowell as a musician who was humiliated online because of a viral proposal gone wrong, Tien Tran as his lesbian sister looking to find love in the big city after a terrible separation, Suraj Sharma as the engaged owner of the bar that they frequent, Francia Risa as Duff's best friend, roommate, and free spirit of the group, and lastly, Tom Ainsley as the British aristocrat who flew across the world to be with her. I was honestly surprised, within the four episodes of the show that were screened for critics, how much I ended up falling for these characters and understanding where the showrunners were going with them. The setup for each character was interesting enough that I am curious to see how they end up and can see myself getting invested in them. The standout here for me is Suraj Sharma, who is able to land almost every joke and has this quirkiness about him that came off more authentic to me than the others. Francia Risa is also one to look out for. In episode 4, she is struggling with the idea of monogamy with her British beau, and I can see her being a character I will be able to relate to as the show goes on. And then we have Tom Ainsley, who is definitely playing the Neil Patrick Harris surrogate of the show, and while his outlandish and over-the-top pomp can be humorous in these four episodes, I can see the shtick getting old really quick. There are definitely qualms I have with the show so far, though, which are mostly ones that I have with the original as well. And that makes me think that if you were not a fan of How I Met Your Mother, you are not going to be a fan of this reiteration either. One thing that jumps out to me is that the show is just not very funny at the moment. A lot of the jokes fall flat, or even worse, can be cringy, just like in the original. I think I caught moments where even the laugh track wasn't cracking up at the jokes that were supposed to be funny. Not a good sign. There were a couple of times that I did end up laughing out loud, though. One moment, which includes a man on the subway who asked Tom Ainsley to open his mouth. That was hilarious, weird, and rooted in experiences that can actually happen living in the big city. If the show is able to capitalize on that kind of offbeat and creative humor, as well as if the cast is able to grow upon their chemistry with each other, I think the showrunners still have a chance in mending these issues in the future. And lastly, and this is a big negative, I just cannot tell you what makes this show special or why you should watch it. Yes, if you love the original, I think you're going to get a kick out of this reboot, but I don't think they've done enough to separate themselves from the first iteration or done enough to make it stand out above all of the other sitcoms out there. The biggest difference with this show is that they are concentrating on love life in the time of dating apps. But we need more than that. And while Hilary Duff is charming as hell and has charisma to spare, this character of Sophie is coming off really bland at the moment. But so did Ted at the beginning too. I hope the showrunners are able to find that right sweet spot of heartfelt emotional moments grounded in our collective experiences, along with the silly situational humor that How I Met Your Mother was able to uncover as it went along. Because as of right now, I'm enjoying what I'm watching because it's bringing me the nostalgia of how I felt watching the original, not because it's necessarily good. But as with all shows like this, if the cast is able to really unearth that chemistry and the writers listen to its audience, this certainly has the potential to be just as good or even better than its predecessor. So I will be giving How I Met Your Father 3.25 Tinder logos out of 5. The showrunners of this new spinoff have done a great job of recreating the vibe of the original and have assembled a talented cast to take over the reins. But they are going to need to do more to stand out above the rest and find their unique perspective, along with hiring a new person to write their jokes. Also, give us more Kim Cattrall. Thank you so much for watching Lost in the Real. I am super curious to hear all of your thoughts on How I Met Your Father. Are you a fan of the first series? Are you excited for this reboot? Or do you think it's too little too late? Sound off in the comment section down below. And until next time, my friends, take care.